What's up, guys? Welcome back to Paul's Hardware. At the beginning of this year, when new GPUs launched, I used my natural cynical skepticism to say, I bet those are going to be overpriced for quite some time. Hence this series, GPU Price Watch, where I've been monitoring the prices of GPUs going back to March. Fortunately, many of the prices have settled down. We have some good news this month on the AMD side of things. And last month, I asked you guys the question, should I even continue doing this? And many of you said yes. So GPU Price Watch continues.
Excellent.
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. So my focus this month is going to be on the best deals you can get at each price tier, but let's start off with a look at the actual chart. This is September's chart from last month. If you look at the lower right area here for the RTX 50 series, as well as our AMD cards, you will note a change as I switch over to October. Look at that, we have much more green and much more white, and that is because many of the AMD cards that were obstinately refusing to come down from being overpriced at $740, $700, $700 for the 9070 XT that's supposed to be $600, we've finally apparently reached a breaking point. The 9070 XT dropped $70 this month to $630, and the 9070 dropped to $550. It's MSRP, so I suppose as we have given Nvidia credit for dropping many of their GPUs in the 50 series finally over time to the MSRP, which isn't fantastic, but it's a lot better than overpaying. So that has affected, to some degree, my recommendations for this month. Also, before I go much further, I want to point out that I'm gathering this data from PC Part Picker's price listings, which typically gathers prices from major retailers like Newegg, Amazon, and Best Buy. I am verifying the lowest prices to make sure it's coming from a reputable retailer and not from a third-party seller that's shady or something like that, and then averaging the 10 cheapest listings to get our average. One last point to make before I move into the deals is the RTX 40 series is listed up here primarily just as a point of reference. The RTX 40 series has not been manufactured since late last year. There is still inventory on the market, but it's typically grossly overpriced, and even for ones that are like maybe a deal, like for instance a $330 4060 Ti 8GB, that's not really a deal because you should be opting for a 50 series card like the 5060 Ti 8GB, more ideally a 16GB card if you can claw your way up to that. Or opt for something on the AMD side like the 9060 XT, ideally the 16GB. Or if you're trying to keep the price down, the B580 at $250, or even the B570, which is now down to $210, are good options too. All right, now I'm gonna run down the best deals or the GPUs I'd recommend at different price tiers, starting with the budget tier, which is $200 to $300 these days. And here you actually have a very difficult choice. If you want to help support Intel's ARC program, but also get a decently performing GPU, Intel has recently updated their ARC drivers, so the driver overhead issue that has caused performance to suffer somewhat with some games if you're running a more budget-oriented CPU like some of the 6-core options on the market. But that has been greatly improved just in the past month or two, which makes the ARC B580 an even easier recommendation at $250. It has been at this price for the past couple months, but it's good that it's no longer selling for $300 plus. And do note that if you're considering crossover AI work or something like that where you need more VRAM, this is the cheapest option to get 12 gigs of VRAM. And then we have an honorable mention with the ARC B570, which is a bit slower than the B580 and has 10 gigs of VRAM instead of 12 gigs, but this one has also come down to $210. Do note that some of these deals require Amazon Prime, so bear that in mind. And then also, speaking of Amazon and Amazon Prime, they have their Prime Day sale going on pretty much right now, which also means a lot of other retailers have coincidental sales that are also going on at the same time, which means there are some discounts right now. None of them are too crazy, but also if you're considering what the best prices are going to be in the next couple months leading up to the Black Friday timeframe, when there usually are some of the best deals you can get for the year, I don't anticipate things getting much better than what we are seeing right now. So if you're on the fence about buying, my recommendation would be to pull the trigger. But getting back to the difficult choice in this price tier, which is basically your Intel Arc B580 versus the AMD Radeon RX 9060 XT. Now the 9060 XT that's less expensive, and it's down to $260 this month, is the 8GB version. And as I've mentioned many times, 8GB is kind of the floor, the entry level for a discrete gaming graphics card right now in 2025, and especially if you're gaming at a high resolution like 1440 versus 1080, and especially if you have a high refresh rate monitor, you're going to want a graphics card with more than 8GB of VRAM to make yourself a little bit more future-proof. So while the 9060 XT is a pretty decent deal at its current price of $260, I want to point out that that is not the cheapest it has been. Back in July, it was down to $250. Still, in terms of raw rasterization performance, the 9060 XT does outperform the B580. So if you're on the fence between the two of these, I'd recommend looking up some benchmark reviews that compare performance, especially with the games that you most want to play, because performance can vary from game to game and game engine to game engine. So looking for something more specifically that meets your needs might mean that an 8GB card like the 9060 XT 8GB makes more sense for you. But then the third choice in this range would be your NVIDIA options. And I still think these are overpriced for the performance you get. The NVIDIA 8GB cards were really cut down this generation, and you're not even really getting fantastic deals on them. The 5060 8GB is just selling for its MSRP of $300. And that is back up from last month when it was $4 off, which was, did you guys scoop that deal while it was available? So plus $3, and I feel like it doesn't even deserve the green and dark green shading here for being just $1 below MSRP. But that is the system that I set up, so I guess I gotta stick with it. I guess maybe an honorable mention, I feel like I shouldn't even be bringing this up, but the 5050 8GB, which again, I would not recommend versus the ARC or the 9060 XT, but it did come down $10. It's selling for below its MSRP, $240 instead of $250. And I suppose that is the first time that that has happened, at least as far as I have been recording, which is why, again, there's a bit more green on the chart this month than last month. Moving up to the $300 to $400 price range, I consider this to be the sweet spot because you're not going to have to compromise in terms of the amount of VRAM you get, because there are good 16GB options like the 9060 XT, 16GB, selling for $350. This is a prime deal. You have to have prime for it, but it's also selling for the same price over on Newegg. $350 right there, add to cart, and you're good to go. Don't even need to do a promo code or anything. I'd say the only downside here is that you're limited to the Power Color Reaper model if you're really trying to stick to that $350 budget. Prices jump by $15 to $20 after that if you're looking for some of the alternative models. But if you don't want to go with the 9060 XT 16GB, you pretty much have to go outside of this price range. I know I'm talking about $300 to $400 options, but the competitor for the 9060 XT 16GB is the RTX 5060 Ti 16GB. I do not recommend the RTX 5060 Ti 8GB, especially since the price went up on that this month. It's still selling for below MSRP, but it's not at $320, where it was slightly easier to recommend. But the flip side there is that the 16GB model has come down in price just by $10, but hey, if we're trying to save money, $10 is $10. Although I guess I have to point out that that is, again, a Prime Day deal. They're really pushing those. This also is our sole representation in the $400 to $500 range, where there really aren't a whole lot of good options right now. So we're going to skip up to the $500 to $600 range, where for the past few months I've been saying, go for a 5070. Yes, it is selling for just straight MSRP at $550, but this has been a very popular card at that price, so it seems there is some balance there between demand and price. Whether you're over on Newegg, where they have this PNY model, this is a 12GB card, which is better than an 8GB card, and I guess the other benefit of the 5070 is there are multiple models that are available at $550. PNY, MSI has their Shadow right now. And as I'm rambling here, I've totally forgotten that actually these are below MSRP. These have $10 promo codes off right now. This is going along with the Fantastech deal, so this might go away soon. But you can get these for slightly less at $540. But you know, it'd be great if you could get a 16GB card for about the same price. And guess what? Thanks to the RX 9070, non-XT finally dropping down to its MSRP at $550. You totally can. This has been $600 or more for pretty much the entire time that I've been monitoring these prices. So now I've kind of switched over. Instead of just saying your number one choice in this price tier is the 5070, I now have an A and a B option. The RX 9070 16GB is totally viable at this price. So again, I would say look at reviews that test the games that you're planning to play, see which one has better performance for you. And then again, you're getting the benefit of a 16GB card with the 9070. So this is good. And what a coincidence that when this card finally has come down to its MSRP, we now also have 5070s dropping a little bit below $550. Again, just $10. That's like the cost of a banana these days or something, right? Isn't that what it's a banana, Michael? What could it cost? I have a couple honorable mentions at this price tier as well. The Radeon RX 7900 XT, which is a previous gen card, but does come with 20 gigs of VRAM. And I pointed this one out last month when it was selling for about $630. It's down to 580 bucks, so worth considering, especially if the 20 gig VRAM buffer is going to help you out. So do not sleep on that one. But then again, we have the RX 9070 XT 16 gig, which has obstinately been at $700, down to $630. This is still $30 over its MSRP, so I think the 9070 non-XT would be the way to go. But again, double check the benchmark numbers that are out there, because at $630, this warrants consideration. At 700 bucks, we don't even need to think about it. All right, above the $500 to $600 range, there are fewer options, and basically you're going to be opting for the Nvidia card that meets that price. At $750, we have the RTX 5070 Ti. Once again, we have multiple options at the MSRP because it's the MSRP. So here you're not gonna save much money, but you can also keep a lookout for like add-ons. These may or may not have value for you. Get Arc Raiders Deluxe Edition plus an Astro Cosmetic Pack. That is perhaps worth thinking about. The other alternative, if you're looking at the 5070 Ti though, would be the 9070 XT, now down to $630. And that'd be more of a value cost savings option. You can check out Tech Power Up if you want a really quick reference. This isn't the end all be all in terms of performance comparisons, but it's a good way to get a quick assessment. For example, the 9070 XT versus 5070 Ti. 5070 Ti is about 5% faster. The next price tier is $1,000. For $1,000, there's the RTX 5080. There it is. I guess you also get that add-on Arc Raiders Deluxe Edition and stuff. But again, here I would not pay much, if at all, over about $1,000 for this card. I really don't see this price moving much at all in the near future, unless AMD suddenly launches some higher tier RX 9000 series card, which doesn't seem to be happening as far as the rumor mill goes. But at the same time, I would not want to pay more than $1,000 for this card, and there are several options at the MSRP. But then the final tier up is the RTX 5090, which is the fastest gaming GPU, love it or hate it, and it is generally selling for above $2,000. Here again, I was somewhat torn because there were clearly listings at $2,000, as there have been sporadically for the past couple months. Back in August, it was available for $2,000. In September, the cheapest one I found was $2,250. And then today there were two listings for $2,000. One of these was in stock briefly, but then it went out of stock. So if you are in the market for an RTX 5090, if you need the VRAM, if you're doing AI stuff, if you just want the best graphics card available, then I'd recommend just being patient, keeping an eye on these listings and waiting for one to come in at the $2,000 price. There were listings on both Newegg and Best Buy for this card, but as of the filming of this video, they're out of stock. But there it is, you guys. Those are the best GPUs that you can currently buy if you're buying a new retail graphics card in the US in October. And I think I will continue this series, but I'm gonna, again, just focus on like, what are the deals? Here's what I recommend at certain price points. And then including the ongoing price watch spreadsheet, just so you guys can have a point of reference for anyone who's been diligently following along the vicissitudes of GPU pricing in 2025. Thank you guys so much for watching this video though. I'll post links to the best deals I found in the description down below. There's also a link to my store down there at pulsehardware.net where you can buy shirts, mugs, and pint glasses. Great way to support the channel and get yourself some nice merch. If you wanna hit the thumbs up button on the way out, that's greatly appreciated as well. Subscribing, also highly recommended. Thanks again for watching this video, and we'll see you all in the next one.